everyone, and welcome back to Biplab World. Now today we're going to discuss a very important issue, and that is climate change. Children, I'm sure you must have all heard or probably read about climate change. And while a lot of you may know what it is, I'm pretty sure a lot of you are also wondering what climate change is, what causes it, and what can we do to stop climate change from getting worse than what it already is. So let me try and explain this to you. As you know, as human beings, we all breathe in air and our body absorbs oxygen, which is so critical for life, and we breathe out carbon dioxide. This carbon dioxide is then absorbed by the plants, they use it for photosynthesis, and they release more oxygen in the atmosphere that helps keeping the balance in nature. So living creatures, animals, humans, we breathe in oxygen, we breathe out carbon dioxide. Plants breathe in the carbon dioxide and they breathe out oxygen, keeping this balance. Over the last 100 years, because of industrialization and because of human activity, the amount of carbon dioxide that we are putting out is way more than what nature can handle. Because of our cars, because of our factories, our industries, all the appliances that we run, you know, the air conditioners, the fans, the lights, every single piece of equipment, even the phone or the laptop or the tab that you're watching this video on, consumes energy. And when that energy is generated in a power plant or anywhere else, it releases carbon dioxide in the atmosphere. We've reached a stage where this quantity of carbon dioxide is so high that it is altering the climate of the world, which means that our summers are getting hotter, they're getting longer, the winters are getting more fierce, which is a little strange. If it's getting hotter, then the winters also should get warmer, right? But that doesn't happen. And in one of our next videos, we will explain why that isn't happening. Point is, this drastic change in the climate is affecting the lives of millions of people across the planet. Not just that, but there are millions of species that we don't even know about as far as their existence is concerned, which are a part of this ecosystem, that are now dying out because of climate change. So it's very important that we do something to first stop the climate from getting worse, and then over a period of time, bring it back to what it probably was maybe 100 or 150 years back. But the big question is, how can we do this without affecting our lifestyle in a very big way? That's what we're going to be discussing in today's video.
Can we hear the video?
Come sit. Come closer. Tell me something. What have both of you got in your hands?
Apple.
Do you know something? This is not an apple, but this is probably one of the biggest villains of climate change.
Really? But apples are healthy.
Apples are healthy. But let me tell you why this apple is a culprit, and that will probably also help all of us understand what small lifestyle changes we can make in our individual lives to stop climate change. As you can see, this apple has got a label in it which says that it is imported from Washington. It gets onto a ship which then takes close to 60 days, almost 2 months, to reach our country. And so that it doesn't go bad in those 2 months, the apple is put in a refrigerated container. So imagine a container which is as big as this hall, completely filled with apples, connected to a power cord
with
not just air conditioning, but a refrigerator. Your air conditioner runs at, yes, a fridge. The air conditioner runs at a temperature of maybe 22 or 24 degrees, whereas the refrigerator runs at a temperature of
maybe 2 or 4 degrees.
2 to 4 degrees, because that's how cold they have to keep it to make sure the fruit doesn't go bad.
Can then you, we can just eat an apple which is grown in India.
Exactly my point. So at Biplab World, we have starting an initiative which is called Buzz for Local. Buzz for Local is a simple initiative where we all take a pledge that every single fruit and vegetable that we consume will be grown in India. We don't consume any fruit or vegetable that is imported from anywhere else in the world. Simple reason that these innocent looking vegetables have a huge carbon footprint, because like I explained, when it takes 2 months to come from a foreign country to India, in those 2 months, it is consuming a lot of energy to remain fresh. And that energy, when it is produced, it releases, what does it release in the atmosphere?
Carbon dioxide.
And that is adding to the amount of harmful carbon dioxide in the atmosphere, and that is causing?
Climate change.
So today, are we going to make a pledge that we are going to have only local fruits and vegetables?
Yes.
Are you all going to participate in Buzz for Local with Biplob?
Yes.
Awesome. So I hope you also promise to take this pledge with us. We're going to follow this up with many more videos, sharing more insights on how you and I can make simple lifestyle changes like Buzz for Local, so that we can reduce our carbon footprint and we can reduce the amount of carbon dioxide that we put out in the atmosphere. Now let's not waste these apples. Go for it, and we'll see you in the next video with one more interesting story to share about something to do with nature, our environment, or climate change. Till then,
Buzz for Local!